Hello fellow makers, I am Hypermix and in this video I will tell about the assembly I did for the all of the electronics in the e-bike. As you can see, this is the display, this is the ESC that is controlling the motor, and also the throttle. So we will talk about this in details one by one. So coming to the throttle, as you can see here, it is a half twist throttle and it comes with its key, and this key turns on the display. Actually this key will turn on the display, then we have to turn on the display in order to control the motor or it will not start. So now it is in on position. I will turn on the display, press and hold, and as you can see, the display has turned on. Another thing that you have to keep in mind, that your display should be compatible with your controller, right? So my display was provided by my seller, which is KT LCD3 actually, and which has inbuilt LCD backlight. As you can see, just press and hold the up button, it will turn on and off. In the next video, I will tell about setting the parameters of this LCD so that you will be able to easily control the parameters of the motors also. It is very important, because it will show wrong information in display if you have not set properly the parameters of the display. Next thing is, you can see and notice that my gear shifters are integrated with the brakes, so I was not able to use e-brakes, but I did order some e-sensors, e-brake sensors. As you can see, I will show you right here. I am not sure if you are able to see it or not, but this part, as you can see, this part and in this side also, you can see this sensor right here. These sensors are activated using a magnet, as you can see right here. I have not set it up with this sensor for the safety purposes now, but as you can see here, I will show you. In this brake, yeah, there you can see the magnet which activates the sensor for braking the motor. After that, we come to wire management or cabling. As you can see, all the wires for the sensors, for the display, for the controller, as you can see, I have used cable ties, right? Big cable ties, small cable ties. What it does is that it keeps the, you know, it looks clean. Actually it looks very clean, and it keeps the wire from getting in your, you know, movement space when you pedal the bike. And as you can see here also, I have used very big cable ties, actually very big cable ties, so that I can very firmly mount my controller to the frame of the bike. Next thing comes is the wiring of all the sensors, ESC and motor. As you can see, all my wiring is done here only, and if you look carefully, I have applied hot glue in every intersection, as you can see, where the wire meets the connector. This will help at least keep some shorting or water to get inside the connectors, and it will be a little bit more weatherproof. Another thing that is to be kept in mind, that is, your seller will normally provide you with a manual, or if he has not provided, then you can check their site in online. Surely there will be a manual, and using that manual you can actually know about the parts that has been provided to you. And here is the manual, as you can see, telling about all the details and information you need to know on how to mount and unmount all the sensors, motors and controller. Also, as you can see, how it has clearly given how to connect all the connectors for battery, sensors, motors. So it is very helpful actually for beginners and novice who are trying to convert their normal mountain bike to an e-bike. For For converting a normal MTB to an e-bike, the main sensor you require is pedal assist, obviously. And now I will show you how to mount that pedal assist in your bike.
Sugar, there's a reason why we lose.
So that's all for the sensors that I've installed in my bike for now. But still I have two things to be mounted, that is a, you know, there is a plug, as you can see, a small plug connector here, which can provide the direct battery voltage, right? So this has been provided for if you want to mount a headlight or a horn. So I have to mount two things. One is that a 48 volt to 12 volt converter. I'm thinking of mounting it somewhere here of the free space. And the another thing is I will mount a phone holder maybe in this side, which can be connected to the 12 volt converter. If you are curious on how I mounted my hub motor, pre-assembled hub motor in the frame, or the DIY e-bike battery which I assembled myself, then you can obviously check out my e-bike conversion playlist, which will be showing in the iCard right now. If you guys have any queries or any questions you would like to know, then you can just post it in the comment section and I will try my level best to answer it. Till then, wear masks and stay safe.